There's no how-to guide for filmmaking, although most YouTube criticism would have you believe that there is. But if we can point to any director's work for bullet points on how to engage an audience, Edgar Wright is at or near the top of that list. The opening scenes of Wright's latest film, Baby Driver, as well as Nicholas Winding Refn's Drive, are two of the best in recent years because of their almost wordless introductions to their film's protagonist, as well as establishment of internal logic that will lead the viewer through the movie. Sound is crucial to both these films in formulating momentum. Baby Driver is guided almost exclusively by its soundtrack, with each scene designed around a given song. In the case of this first heist in Getaway, it's Bellbottoms by John Spencer Blues Explosion. Like Baby Driver, Drive is notable for its own dreamlike soundtrack of swirling synth, an abstract musical accompaniment intended to engage you with the protagonist's emotional perspective, if not his moment-to-moment experience like Baby and his headphones. Sound and soundtrack will play a crucial role in both these Getaways. I'm giving you a night call, tell you how I feel. Heists always begin with the setup. In setting the scene and the whole movie, Baby Driver plants the seed of a character element before we've even seen anything, transitioning a high-pitched ringing into a musical note, then into the squeal of brakes as a car enters frame. This fully encapsulates the dynamic between Baby, his inner ear tinnitus and need to drown out with music, as well as his vocation as a getaway driver. All of this is accomplished with nothing but sound and one image, minutes before the relationship is made explicit by dialogue.
What? How many of those do you have?
Oh, I got different iPods for different days and moods.
The next shot is an iPod, shown playing a song the viewer is about to hear, as a headphones-clad baby appears to break the fourth wall and look right at us, until the next shot, introduced on beat, shows him looking at another member of the heist crew. In a few seconds and no words, the two pillars of Baby Driver are constructed. Baby's connection to music, and the viewer's subsequent engagement with the film through his ears. The form of the movie serves the function. Baby's world is alive with music. It makes sense that his film echoes that to the audience. As the titles fade and the film proper is about to start, a metronomic pulse begins. The song Tick of the Clock by Chromatics. This is the heartbeat of the scene, quickening or easing to tell you when Gosling's character, known only as the driver, is starting to worry. Drive showcases a mastery of setup and payoff throughout this scene and beyond. The first thing we see is the route mapped out as we hear the driver set his rules.
You give me a time and a place, I give you a 5-minute window. Anything happens in that 5 minutes and I'm yours, no matter what.
Our attention is then drawn to a basketball game, which will be important later. As the robbers enter the building, the music is joined by the ticking of a stopwatch, followed by a police scanner, then radio coverage of the basketball game. These are the four fundamental audio components of the scene, smartly unveiled in the order that they'll become obsolete to the driver's task. For 21 seconds, we're exposed to no stimulus other than these four elements, until the first robber emerges from the building and we get our first shot from the exterior of the car before rejoining the interior action. It's a momentary, partial release of tension, but the job is not over.
Come on.
We stay with Baby outside despite the action of the scene following his crew into the bank. Although the emphasis is on Baby during this setup, he's always shot from outside the car. Combining with his teenage nonchalance, it emphasizes his disconnect from this life of crime. Meanwhile, Gosling's driver is composed in increasingly tight close-ups. He's switched on, all in. In both scenarios, police sirens break any semblance of calm.
Come on!
Get it!
As Baby Driver's heist finishes, the camera pushes in closer to Baby and begins alternating cuts between inside and outside the vehicle, naturally shifting the action to the next arena. A great way to analyse the intent of a scene is to count the shots. The entire 313-second sequence from Baby Driver consists of 222 shots, making the average shot length a microscopic 1.4 seconds, not factoring in the final 23-second long shot. Drive's longer 416-second scene is made up of only 133 shots, resulting in an average shot length of 3.1 seconds, over twice as slow as Baby Driver. This accurately reflects Drive's more deliberate pacing in contrast to Baby Driver's frenetic action, which is fine, but it's not the whole story. Of Baby Driver's total shots, 136 are from outside the car, leaving 86 for internals. That's around a 60-40 favouring of exterior shots. In contrast, only 22 of Drive's shots are outside the car, with 111 inside. That's an 83-17 split in favour of interiors. Winding-Refn maintains the geometry of the car's movement, despite shooting almost exclusively in these interiors, to make his getaway incredibly immersive. Wright often chooses either to mount the camera on the vehicle or shoot from a vantage point, but he isn't really interested in reflecting continuity of movement. The view is made to fill in for jumps in time through implied motion we never actually see. This allows Wright to trim the fat of these car chases to the bare minimum, so the song can drive the action while maintaining the scene's coherence. Both directing methods are masterful in their own way. Even if we scale up Baby Driver's sequence to match Drive, the average shot is still only 1.9 seconds long. So what does this all tell us? On a basic level, it's indicative of Baby Driver's getaway acting less as a real-time depiction of a car chase, and more as a choreographed dance. Thematically, however, the intention can go much deeper, placing Baby's disillusionment towards his line of work in stark opposition to his true passion for music. Baby Driver is a very plot-driven movie, and Wright's more objective approach to the images necessarily reflects that, partly because his use of sound is so subjective. On the other hand, by emphasising interiors so much, Winding-Refn highlights Drive as far more character-driven. The story of Gosling's unnamed driver is a fairy tale, following him finding a sense of humanity as he meets Irene and her son, allowing a little light into his dark world. Un-Disney-fied fairy tales are often very bleak, so while the driver is eager to do what's right, it's in his nature to attack, even at a cost to himself or those he cares about. Hence the appropriation of College and Electric Youth's Real Hero as Drive's spiritual theme song. Both these movies are spiritual successors to Walter Hill's 1978 film, The Driver. The Driver character is the modern-day cowboy, an archetypal American hero, swapping leather saddles for leather seats, bridles for pedals, and stirrups for steering wheels. The driver operates predominantly at night, going to work as the rest of the world goes to sleep. There's reason behind this, as the driver does not mix well with others. Baby is softer than previous drivers, as the film goes out of its way to highlight his disgust at the world of crime.
I mean, I don't think actually strong silent type isn't the thing. I think he is somebody that, like, he's silent, and I don't know if you would agree, but I think he gets stronger as the film goes on. As he starts to have to, at the start of the movie, he's a more passive character because he is essentially like an unpaid intern, like as a sort of like...
Fetching the coffee for the bank robber.
Yeah, he's like... On one hand, he's like the badass driver who pulls off this amazing chase in the opening 5 minutes. And then in the very next scene, he's told to go and get the coffees.
Baby's journey is a reimagining of existing tropes in the purest Wrightian sense. An expansion and refinement of a concept first seeded in his music video for Mint Royale's Blue Song.
Right through my head. I ain't got the blues no more, I say.
Edgar Wright's films all play style over substance. He makes stories we've seen before a lot more interesting.
You're a doctor. Deal with it.
Yeah, motherfucker.
That's the main criticism of his work, and it's a valid one. Drive, meanwhile, is not a remake of The Driver, but this opening Getaway is certainly a high-energy tribute to the quiet tension of its 1978 forebear. Nicholas Winding-Refn is very much an artist. However, Baby Driver indicates that Edgar Wright is becoming less of a fan and evolving into an artist in his own right. A car is only ever as good as the driver behind the wheel, and a movie car chase is only as good as its director. This video isn't a how-to guide, but these are just two approaches to consider when constructing a car chase for your movie.
They call me Baby Driver, and once upon a pair of wheels on the road, and I'm gone. What's my number? I wonder how your engines feel.
No.